Hello and welcome to a Minecraft video. I'm Scootabuyo playing Vanilla Minecraft 1.8.7 PC Edition, and this is the seventh in a series of videos in which I conquer an ocean monument. In this video, I'm going to be searching for a sponge room after having drained the water from inside the penthouse. So I will be heading back over to the monument where I left off in the last video. However, it turns out that finding a sponge room in this monument is relatively easy. So most of this video is actually going to be dedicated to how to find a sponge room in the more general case. And for that, I need to go to my full-scale model of an ocean monument. Okay, here I am at my full-scale exploded model of an ocean monument. This is not actually, of course, a real ocean monument. This is just a mock-up that I made. We can see here the different units that make up the maze of the ocean monument. In my mock-up, every single one of the 46 units is an identical room with all openings open. Generally speaking, well, that's not going to be the case. All of these rooms instead, some of these units will become individual rooms. Some of these units will combine with adjacent units in order to become larger rooms. What I'm concerned with for finding a sponge room to start off with, though, is not what this specific arrangement of rooms is in the monument, because I don't know what that is yet. I'm concerned with which of the 46 units can possibly become sponge rooms. And the key restriction here is that a sponge room can have only an opening to the room beneath it. So a specific unit becomes a sponge room if there's an exit from the sponge room only to the room beneath it. And that means all of the rooms or the units of the bottom layer of the maze here, none of them can potentially be sponge rooms. And the units that are adjacent to the wings over here, here's one, and there's another one on the other side. These always have an opening to the wing, and so these cannot be a sponge room either. And then there's one more that has access to the penthouse right here. The unit beneath the penthouse cannot be a sponge room either, because it always has an exit in the ceiling, and that violates the condition of a sponge room. Of the 46 units that make up the maze of the ocean monument, fully 23 of them cannot possibly become sponge rooms. What I'm interested in the ones that can become sponge rooms, but it turns out that they can't become sponge rooms with equal likelihood. Due to the way in which the ocean monument is generated, some of the units that can possibly become sponge rooms are more likely to become sponge rooms than others. And those are the rooms that have fewer adjacent, or those are the units that have fewer adjacent units to them. So this unit right here, for example, it has one, two other units adjacent to it, and another one down here, so that it has three adjacent units. But over here is basically the front facade of the ocean monument. There's no unit over here, so there's no way this can possibly connect to a unit over here. And likewise, there's the side of the ocean monument over here, and the same thing for above. So of the six potential, of the six directions away from this particular unit, three of them can't have any units adjacent to them just because of the shape of the ocean monument. So this has only three units adjacent to it. And it turns out that's the most likely to become a sponge room. So I'm going to go ahead and mark this with red, because it has only three units adjacent to it. And all of the other units that can possibly become sponge rooms that have only three units adjacent to them, I'm going to mark. That's all of these corners up here on this upper layer of units. And it also includes, so there's three layers of units. There's a two by three configuration of units, and the middle layer is a 4x5 configuration of units, and the bottom layer is a 4x5 configuration of units. None of the bottom ones can be sponge rooms, but the ones in the middle can. Over here in the corner, this only has three units adjacent to it, and this one over here in the corner over here also has only three units adjacent to it. So those are all of the ones that have only three units adjacent to them. Now there are also other units that have only four units adjacent to them. So this unit right here has a unit below it, a unit to the right over there, a unit to the left, and a unit behind it. So it has four units adjacent to it. This one can't be a sponge room though, because remember this one has the access to the penthouse above. But this unit right here has only four units adjacent to it, so I'm going to go ahead and mark those with orange. And then there are a number in this middle layer of units down here that also have only four units adjacent to them. This one here, this one here, and all of these in back. As well as this one here, and this one here. But not this one, because this one has access to the wing, so it can't be a sponge room. Okay, and so those are the units that have only four units adjacent to them. Up here, we're all finished. We've already marked all the units that can possibly be sponge rooms. And now the units where there are can only be five units adjacent to them, I'm going to go ahead and mark those. This one can only have five units adjacent because the top of the ocean monument is up here. So this one, and this one, and then this one here, and this one here. Oops. All right, there we go. Okay, and the remaining units have six units adjacent to them, one in all directions. So I'm just going to go ahead and mark those. Okay, and so now I've marked all of the units that can possibly become a sponge room. And so we get a nice visualization of where we should be concentrating our efforts. You can see that I have a really good likelihood of finding a sponge room in one of these five units up on this upper layer here. The corner units all have a pretty good likelihood of becoming sponge rooms, and the one in the back center also has a pretty good chance. Down here, the ones that are closer to the front have less of a possibility of becoming sponge rooms, but the ones around the edges and in back also have pretty good likelihood. So I'm going to be starting then my search for a sponge room from the top, and that's where I left off in the penthouse here. And it turns out these five units are really easy to check because they are there is a block of the roof over these units that is part of the floor of the penthouse. So if I just go over to the corners of the penthouse, and I knock out this prismarine block, I can look down directly into that unit and see whether or not it's a sponge room. And the same thing is over here for this corner. I can check another room. And if I head over to the corner over here, I can check another room. And the corner over here, I can check another room. And lastly, if I poke out one of the blocks in the middle here, I can check that middle room down there with the orange marking it. So I've been able to check all five of the rooms here to see whether or not they're a sponge room. Remember, these have one of these has a pretty good chance of becoming a sponge room when the ocean monument generates. So already I have a really good chance of finding a sponge room, and I haven't had to go anywhere. I've already drained the penthouse. I just needed to poke five holes, and I could check all five of those rooms. Now, if none of those five rooms is a sponge room, then I'm going to have to go down and start looking at the rooms in the middle layer here. And there, it turns out that there's a hard way to do that and an easy way to do that. I'm concerned more with the easy way. So what I'm going to do then, if I do not find a sponge room from the top five units here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to check out one of the units in the corner, in the front corners here, either this one over here or this one over here with this hole. Whichever one appears that it will be easier for me to clear out with the three sponges that I have so far, I'm going to go ahead and go down there. I'm going to drain that room, and then I'm going to enter the upper passageway. And that is this passageway right here that's very narrow along here, along the sides, each side, but it's wider in back. It turns out that this passageway is not very difficult to clear out. It maybe takes me 15, 16 sponges. So I can clear that out relatively easily. And from there, I have access to a significantly larger, a significant number of the rooms of the middle layer that could be sponge rooms. So the floor of the passageway around here, I can check this room here, I can check this room here, I can check these rooms here, this room, this room, this room, this room, basically all the way around. It's a little bit difficult to check this one in the front middle, and it's a little bit difficult to, you can't check directly the rooms of the middle layer and back. Those will require a little bit of special treatment, but it turns out that two of the five of these are going to become part of the treasure room, and it's very easy to tell which of those two they are. So we'll only have to check three of those in back. So by clearing out that upper passageway, I get access to almost everything else to check whether or not it's a sponge room, which makes it pretty easy to determine whether the monument has a sponge room. I can do that relatively quickly without having to do a lot of exploration of draining or draining. So I'm going to switch now to a different world. I'm just going to generate a random world and go to the first ocean monument that I notice, and we'll take a look and see if we can find a sponge room in that. Okay, here I am in the penthouse of an ocean monument in a new random world. This ocean monument was actually really close to the spawn point, but I don't really know anything about it, except the fact that I've killed the Elder Guardian in the penthouse here and drained it. Now I'm getting ready to go through the monument and look for a sponge room. So the very first thing I'm going to do then is, marks the front of the monument over here. I'm going to check the five units of that top layer of units by punching five holes around in this the penthouse starting with the corner over here. So there's a prismarine block underneath that can't possibly be a sponge room. Not a sponge room. I'm going to come around here and check down here. Just poke a hole in one of these. There's a sponge room already, so great. I found one sponge room already. Gonna poke a hole here. There's another sponge room, so this monument has at least two sponge rooms, and that one's not a sponge room. So I've already found two sponge rooms. Again, those five units on that upper layer of units are pretty likely to have sponge rooms in them. So I would go down here and grab these sponges. I would seal up the lone exit from the sponge room, and a lot of the volume of sponge rooms are taken up by wet sponges, so they're pretty easy to clear out. Just grab all the sponges in here, add them to my inventory, and then continue draining the interior of the monument. Okay, so that's one sponge room there. And there was another sponge room over here. Oops. Seal this one up. This creates a water break to make draining the water from this particular room more efficient. And there we go, and I grab all of these. So each sponge room is going to contain roughly a half stack of sponges. Could be a little bit more, could be a little bit less. But around a half stack is the general rule. So now I've already found two rooms that had sponges. Even if I had just found one, I could continue draining the water from the interior. Supposing I did not find a sponge room, in that case I would have to continue looking for a sponge room. And in order to do that, I would choose one of these two rooms in the front, either this one or that one over here, in order to clear it out so that I could have access to that upper passageway. That room over there, because this prismarine, this block of prismarine bricks is right here, that means this is going to be a relatively small room. It'd probably be a good choice. So I go down here. And there's this is actually a room that's that has two that combines two units. I'm going to go ahead and just clear this out really fast. I'm not using my clearing procedure, but just to get the water out of here to show how we would continue looking for a sponge room here. All right, so I got that. This would have been blocked off by a water break. Okay, so there we are. I entered over here and come back up, meaning the front of the monument is over here. The access to the upper passageway is right here. Now, it doesn't necessarily have any visible axes to it. It kind of depends upon the room configuration of the middle layer of units. I know that I can access that upper passageway by just going through here. So I'd probably get rid of this brick here, and right here, I'd want to place a door in order to prevent water from spilling in. I'd poke this hole, and there's the upper passageway right there. I'd drop a sponge in here to clear out some of the water, and then I'd remove it and finish my access over here. So now I could go ahead and just continue clearing out this. I'm going to clear out this, not really following a procedure either, just to get rid of the water, so I can continue looking for a sponge room here. But clearing out this lower passage, again, you know, maybe takes anywhere between 15 and 20 sponges, even if it's done a little sloppily. So it's not too bad. An unhappy guardian over there. Okay, so there is sometimes breaks in the floor of this upper passageway that provide access up here. There are potential ways up here, but right now I'm not really worried about that, except in so far as it helps me search for a sponge room. So I'm going to want to check along the pattern of prismarine along the floor here. You notice that some places here prismarine bricks are exposed. These prismarine bricks are actually forming the walls of the unit of different rooms down in that middle layer of units, and the prismarine is a generated ceiling for those. And it turns out that the particular pattern of this prismarine allows us some insight into what the rooms down below look like. So I can see down here, for example, that this is not a sponge room because I can actually look because of this break. I don't know if there are any others around. Let me go check over here. It doesn't look like there are any other breaks in the floor. But what we can tell about some of these units is due to the shape of this prismarine here. So let me start over where I entered this upper passageway. This room here, prismarine floor here, this actually is potentially a I guess it's not, because I can see down there in there. If this had been covered, this might be a sponge room, but it's not. There's the Elder Guardian from the wing over there. So I know that's not a sponge room over here. Now over here, you see that the prismarine extends all the way across the floor. That indicates a room that comprises at least two units. So if I kind of took a peek down in here, let me come down into this room here. Okay, so this room down here has two units because that ceiling needed to generate all the way across. Let's see if I can find my way out here. That ceiling needed to generate all the way across, which is why the prismarine extends all the way to the wall of this of the upper passageway here. This one over here, this one also can't be a sponge room because it's got a break. I can see down inside it. But if the prismarine did not extend, if it just extended over to this block here, that would indicate a potential room that was comprised one unit, and that's potentially a sponge room. In this case, none of the rooms over here can potentially be a sponge room. So I'm going to head over to the other side. And likewise, this prismarine floor extends all the way to the wall of the upper passageway. So this unit, the units that's underneath over here and the unit that's underneath over here, those combine to form a single room. And sponge rooms can't be two units large, so neither one of those units can be a sponge room either. Now this one is the more interesting case, because here the prismarine does not extend all the way over, which means that this prismarine is just covering a single unit room, and so that could be a sponge room. So I'd probably want to take a look, and wow, that is a sponge room. That was a nice surprise. So I'd go ahead and seal that off and drop down some dry sponges, and now I can clear the sponges from this room. This monument so far has generated with three sponge rooms, which is actually quite a lot. All right, so continuing my search here. Now I've gone all the way around the side except for this bit over here. You'll notice that this prismarine extends all the way to this back wall over here. This prismarine over here and this little bit that we can see right here, this only go to this block over here, but this prismarine right here goes all the way to the wall of the upper passageway here. This large segment of prismarine indicates the treasure room. So the treasure room is underneath here, and it extends two units in that direction, which means that the only three units of the middle layer that I can't really check, that I have to do a little bit more investigating, are going to be from here, here, and here, all kind of all the way in the back. I won't have to check these units here for sponges, because these are all part of the treasure room, and they cannot there are no sponges in the treasure room. So I would want to check in back of here, and I would want to check in back of here. Probably I'd end up having to do a little bit of swimming for that. I do have a much more complicated procedure for kind of getting out there, but it's generally more trouble than it's worth. It's usually easier to just enter one of these rooms, clear it out, or create an airlock, and then just go manually check. Maybe I'd clear this room out, and then I'd poke a hole in these walls and go check these back units here. And none of them are sponge rooms though. So, and that's more or less it. I've The best chance that I have for spundrum is actually going to be in that in those upper five units of that upper layer of units, and those are going to those all have a relatively high likelihood of being spundrums. If I don't find them, then I'm going to choose a room of those five, one of the front rooms of the one of the units in the corners, in the front corners. Whichever one is easier to clear out, I'm going to head down there and just clear it out with my three sponges. And from there, I will have access to the upper passageway, clear out the upper passageway, and then I have access to almost everything else. Now that we've done this sort of in concept, I'm going to return to my survival world where I can actually do that. I guess not a survival world. I'll return to the return to the instructional world where I'm conquering that ocean monument in order to do that in survival mode. Okay, I'm back inside the ocean monument that I'm conquering here, that I've been conquering for the past videos. This is where I left off at the end of the previous video when I drained the penthouse. I'm going to go ahead and dry out my my wet sponges using some planks while I start poking holes in the floor. So here's the my cobblestone square. That means this is the front of the monument. And so I'm going to go ahead and let's just start over here. And sponge room right away. That was really convenient. I'm just going to check the other units just to be sure. So there's no sponge room down there. I need to check the unit that's kind of under the middle here. Let's check here. No sponge room over there. Let's check this corner. No sponge room there. I did lose a block of prismarine. I think I'm going to go get that quick. I can do that just by placing a ladder so I get back up. Okay, and let me check over here. And there's another sponge room. I can see the sponge right over there. So now that I've got my dried out sponges, I can go in there. I'm going to be using some ladders to create a water break on the for the hole in the floor that I know is in the sponge room, and I'm going to prepare some doors just to throw up a barrier in case there's a guardian in there. So let's just drop down here, and it's pretty dark. Let me just throw down some sponges already. Okay. And was a little bit of water left over. Okay. Didn't need to put down the water break, but I'm going to add it right now anyway. Probably I should have dropped a jack-o'-lantern somewhere on the floor to provide me a little bit of light, but that's fine. As soon as you start placing down dry sponges and create some air blocks, get rid of some of the water, things lighten up quite a bit. So, and it's kind of a waste of durability to break sponges with tools because it doesn't really matter what you break them with; it's all pretty much the same. And in fact. It's getting a little dark in this corner, so I'm gonna go ahead and drop a couple of torches around just to be able to see a little bit better. Again, the lighting is both for my benefit and to avoid bat spawning, but I don't actually have to worry about any other hostile mobs spawning because no hostile mobs can spawn in the volume of the ocean monument except for guardians. And as guardians require water for spawning, which means that once they drain the water, they can't spawn either. So one more sponge, and that is all the sponges here. Now I'm gonna need to get back up there. I'm gonna move this torch just so that I don't accidentally break it. And I'll just use water to get back up. I prefer to use water rather than leaving ladders and cobblestone pillars everywhere. Okay, so that was one of my sponge rooms. Where was the other one? Right here. So I'll go ahead and grab this one. And the last time I couldn't see, so I'm going to get some jack-o'-lanterns ready here. Probably I can start providing a little bit of light by putting a torch there. That will light things up a little bit for me. But I'm still going to get a jack-o'-lantern ready. I will need some dry sponges, so I'm headed back to my furnace, which is over here, I guess. Now I have plenty of sponges, so I can start using my charcoal. Let's go ahead and dry some of those out. Anything else I need? I've got my ladders, my doors. We'll need the torches, jack-o'-lantern, I think that's all I'll need for getting down there safely and getting the remainder of those sponges. I will need at least two sponges. Is usually sufficient for clearing out a sponge room, but I'll just make sure that I have three. Okay, and let's go ahead and head down here. Drop a dry sponge and a dry sponge. And yeah, it's all gone, so. Let's post put in my water break there. Not really necessary at this point, but it does make it easier for me to get back up in case I fall in there. And again, it is getting a little dark. I'm going to go ahead and put up a couple of torches here. Let's get that one. So I had gotten three sponges from killing the Elder Guardians. Those were my first three that I'm using to kind of bootstrap. Removing water from inside the monument here. Then I believe I got 26 from that first sponge room. Let's see how much I get from this one. The general rule is a half stack of sponges per sponge room. Don't see any guardians around, that's good news. There's going to be a lot fewer of them inside now that the cover's in place. Okay, so we've got 33 there, and I had taken three from the furnace. So all told, I have almost a stack of sponges. That's pretty good. Let's go ahead and add some more charcoal there. Now I've got a good inventory of sponges. I didn't actually even need to check that middle layer of units. So from here, I'm going to go ahead and just one unit at a time drain the entire inside of the monument. I'm first going to start with that... two by three configuration of units. It results in a small number of rooms. I've already drained two of them because those were the two sponge rooms. So I'll just finish draining those, and then I'll drain the upper passageway, and then continue draining all the different units from the maze before starting in on some of the larger rooms. So that's it for this video. I've got enough sponges to continue draining the rest of the monument. Thanks very much for watching, and if you have any questions or suggestions, please leave a note in the comments.